We have breaking news from the NHL. NHL insiders are reporting that the NHLPA is set to approve the proposed plan from the NHL for return to action. How's this going to work? And when might we finally get hockey? We'll discuss all that coming up next. So welcome back to another video here at Top Shelf Hockey. Now, as I mentioned, we have some breaking news from the NHL this evening. NHL insiders, including Elliot Friedman, Chris Johnston, as well as Bob McKenzie, have all been reporting that it appears as though the NHLPA appears set to approve the plan for the return to plan action here from the NHL, which was a 24-team playoff format that we've discussed on a couple of times here in the last few days. We had our latest update on that 2 days ago, outlining the format and how it was going to work. Essentially, it's 24 teams would be involved in the return to play. The remainder of the regular season would be scrapped, and we'd head straight into a tournament type setting for the Stanley Cup. Now, essentially, the top four teams in each conference would get a bye past the first round, and then the remaining eight teams in each conference, teams 5 down through 12, would do a play-in style of tournament to get into the round of 16, where the official NHL playoffs, I guess you could say, would get underway, and we'd be back to a little bit more of a traditional format that most of us are used to. Now, it's also been reported now that it is possible that the top four teams, the seedings of that could change while the initial round is taking place. Now, the original four teams in each conference that will get a bye, of course, one of their concerns is that they won't get any action, get any play until the second round, where the other teams are going to have a bit of an unfair advantage, already having some game action under their belt. So those teams that are getting a bye will play each other, and there is some talk that those results from those games could very well impact the top four seedings. But the format would be set for how the tournament would work, as I mentioned in the other video. Essentially, you'd have 5 would play 12, 6 would play 11, 7 would play 10, and 8 would play 9, with all of them facing one of the predetermined sets from the top four teams that are getting a bye in the first round. So the 5 versus 12 matchup would then play the fourth place finisher, and then you'd have 6 versus 11 play the third place, 7 versus 10 would play the second place team, and then of course 8 versus 9, the winner of that will go on to play the top seed of the conference. So obviously we could have some very interesting matchups, and early on as well as in the round 2, some matchups we may have never seen before with this unique format. I've seen some people complain about it, say it's not traditional, you know, that this season's gonna have an asterisk next to it, etc. And I really don't think that's the case. If anything, players are gonna have to work even harder to overcome all the obstacles that we've had to even play and to win a Stanley Cup after all this. I really don't see it being being any less legitimate than previous ones. We've had a couple of shortened seasons due to NHL lockouts in the past, where they only played a 48-game season, and nobody's looked upon that one any differently, so I don't really see this being the case here either. So the reports are indicating now, of course, from the NHLPA's committee, which is a representative from each team, so it has 31 members. They'd have to have at least 18 votes to secure a yes vote to proceed with the plan, that it appears as though all these insiders are reporting that the votes are there and this plan will be approved. Of course, there's still going to be plenty of other details to work out before they can make an official announcement on when hockey's going to come back, but we should have an announcement from the NHL possibly over the weekend or within a couple days at least, that this plan to return is approved by both sides and how it's going to work. And then from there, we'll talk here briefly about what other details need to be ironed out before we're going to know the rest of how everything is going to work. But the 2014 format is set to proceed. And of course, the next thing that they need to figure out, or a couple of the next things, is one, what are the hub cities going to be? And then of course, when can we expect to have some game action? Now, based on what the insiders are reporting, it looks as though Edmonton's pushing very hard to be a hub city. Elliot Friedman in his latest blog indicated he'd be shocked if Vegas wasn't involved in some capacity. I did see another report indicating that Vegas may not be an initial city hub, but could possibly host conference finals or the Stanley Cup finals. So it is possible that they may end up hosting like near the end, and maybe have an Eastern hub and a Western hub. Now, the Western hub, as I said, the Oilers are pushing really hard and everybody involved there, and it sounds like they'd have a terrific setup from a variety of standpoints, and they have quite a case to be a host. I know I've heard Columbus emerging lately as an Eastern host if they really want to have a Western or an Eastern. I'm not really sure that the NHL is overly picky on that. Of course, safety comes first above everything else, and being able to accommodate what they need to be able to play and play safely. So it's hard to say exactly who's going to host, but of course that's a key detail on how to get everything ironed out. The NHL would have to move to the next phase where teams are allowed to congregate in larger groups as well. You get players that are going to have to be coming back from all different parts of the world to get back to their NHL cities. And it's believed that we probably wouldn't have a training camp until sometime in early July. So we're probably looking at a little bit over 30 days from now, probably 4 to 5 weeks when training camp would open, and then they'd have a 2 to 3 week training camp with hockey actually resuming action near the end of July. We're probably looking at approximately 2 months before everything would be completed. So we're probably looking at the Stanley Cup being awarded somewhere near the end of September or thereabouts, depending on how long everything takes. The round one, the play-in round, to get to the round of 16 would be a best out of five, with all subsequent series being a best out of seven. So with all those other details needing to be worked out, that would give the league, another 3 to 4 weeks to get all that ironed out before everything would proceed. So this is good news. It's a big step in the right direction to get hockey to come back. Obviously, we want these players to be safe. We want everything to be done properly. But at the same time, strictly from a fan perspective and from an entertainment perspective, it would be really awesome if we could have a really fun and entertaining summer hockey tournament to award the 1920 Stanley Cup. And as far as next year goes, it certainly would be delayed. Clearly, if the Stanley Cup's not going to be handed out until possibly late September, we're probably looking at having a draft shortly thereafter, maybe early October. I'm not really sure exactly. That's just speculation on my part. And then they'd have to allow approximately 45 to 50 days is what was estimated before for an off season, to allow time for free agency and all those kinds of details to be ironed out. And then, of course, the new season would hopefully start when they could have fans in attendance. That's going to be a critical point for the following year, and they very well could delay the start of the year depending on where everything's at with this virus and all the different cities in North America that are impacted and all the teams' locations. Clearly, that is an option that they would prefer to have on the table so they don't lose nearly as much revenue. It's also being reported that since normally June 30th is the end of the calendar year for hockey, and usually free agency begins on July the 1st, that the teams and the leagues are working together here to kind of push all those contracts back and have them extend it until the official new end to the season, which is looking like the end of September. There's some work being done for any kind of coaching or scouting contracts or other parts of the organization as well. There might be a few cases where there's exceptions made to that for some people that are looking to move on to new roles that may not be returning with their existing club. A couple examples would be like Mike Fuda in LA, Judd Brackett in Vancouver. Obviously, there's a few cases like that for members of the executive team or front office members that, are not going to be coming back. They might be able to get around that. But for the most part, we'll have contracts extended here so that September, hopefully, is the end of the year. And then the beginning of the next year could be end of November, maybe possibly December or January. I think it's possible. It just really depends on where things are at with the pandemic. I think the NHL would probably push things as much as they could to get fans in attendance before they start the 2020-21 NHL season. So let me know your thoughts on this big news from the NHL and this format being approved. We should have an announcement soon and we can discuss further down in the comment section. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing and turning on your notifications so you don't miss any future updates to breaking news from around the NHL. Thank you very much for watching, and I will catch you next time.